G'day guys, welcome back to the True Footy YouTube channel and this week's weekly tips video. That's right, in this video you'll be getting just the tips. As you would have seen in last week's video, I scored an immaculate 4 out of 9 tips correctly, but thankfully, the morning of the Sunday games, I changed both tips and ended up getting them both right. So that's why I scored 6 out of 9 and am now winning the tipping competition. So we're back this week to do the exact same thing again, and I'll run you through round 5's games. So on Easter Thursday, the first game of the week is Brisbane Lions hosting the Pies at the Gabba. The Lions were particularly disappointing last week, getting absolutely hammered at the hands of the Dons. In fairness, you could probably say they were kind of in the wrong place at the wrong time, given Essendon really starting to hit their straps for some reason. But the Lions were kind of exposed on the MCG, which typically isn't a happy hunting ground for them. It's quite often the case with young interstate sides to struggle at the MCG, so I don't know if there's anything in that. But for whatever reason, an absolutely red-hot Essendon were able to tear them apart. Neil put in a typically strong shift with 40 possessions through the midfield, but the Essendon mids just had the upper hand all day, to be honest. Now, the Pies so far have been hot and cold this season, no pun intended, and they're sitting at 2-2 after 4 rounds. In fact, they've probably had one convincing performance so far this year against Richmond. They got the points last week over the Bulldogs, as you'd expect, but they weren't quite as dominant as we might have thought they would be, and their ball use in particular was quite poor. The match between Brisbane and Collingwood at the Gabba last year was an absolute belter, and I'm starting to get the feeling could go similar way this year. I reckon in light of the Lions having their confidence shaken last week, I think the Pies will just get up and win a thriller by 5 points. Next up, we have North hosting the Bombers on Good Friday afternoon at Marvel Stadium. Now, as we saw, North got off the mark last week with a good win over Adelaide coming from behind, and that really starts to take the pressure off Brad Scott, but only a little bit. Ben Brown kicked 4 goals, and Sean Higgins was probably best on ground in that game. The inefficiency going forward, though, nearly cost them the game, and they scored just 9 goals from 26 scoring shots. Now, they're coming up against a side in Essendon who's really starting to find their mojo. Now, the Bombers had some brilliant individual performances last week with Merritt, Tippin Woody, and Mitch Brown all playing really well, but as a whole team, they look pretty quick and potent in their attacks. The Dons have put together 2 really good performances in a row, and personally, I don't think the Roos are going to be the team to stop them this week. I'm tipping the Bombers by 38 points. Next up is the Friday night clash between the Eagles and Port Adelaide at Optus Stadium. The Eagles currently sit 3rd on the ladder following 3 wins since their disappointing trip to the Gabba in round 1. They've had really impressive wins against the Giants and the Pies in rounds 2 and 3, but were really bad in round 4 against the Dockers. Now, good teams win ugly sometimes, I do understand that, but I was a little bit concerned at how physically cooked the Eagles look, and at times it looked like the players were running on quicksand. It's probably me just being a pessimistic Eagles fan, but their performance kind of reminded me of their big loss to Essendon last year in Perth. The skill level and drop marks were just terrible all night, and if Fremantle had kicked straighter in the first term, they probably wouldn't have gotten away with it. Now, while the Power didn't necessarily play poorly last week, they'll probably be disappointed not to get the points against an undermanned Richmond side last week. The Tigers were away from home, where they're not typically strong. They had all their guns missing, but fought really hard to record a really good club victory. While the Tigers played with good spirit, it was a really big missed opportunity for the Tigers to go 3-1. Like I said in my Reacts video, I think this adds a little bit more pressure than they would have liked to this Friday night game. Having said that, I believe they'll probably use it to their advantage. I'm going to tip the upset of the round and say Port Adelaide win this by 18 points. Next up, we have the GWS Giants hosting Fremantle at Marnica Oval in Canberra. The Giants are coming off one of the best wins in their short club history, beating the Cats at GMHBA Stadium last week. Barring one blip in round 2 against the Eagles, the Giants look absolutely up and about in 2019. Cornelio and Lockie Whitfield in particular have probably raised their stocks to be considered absolute elite players in the competition for their position. The Dockers, as I mentioned before, put up a pretty respectable performance last week without Nat Fyfe in the Derby. I believe Fyfe is set to play this week, so that is a huge boost for them in the midfield stakes. These two sides have met just once before at Marnica Oval, with the Giants getting the better of the Dockers by 5 goals last year. I predict a similar kind of result this time, and I think the Giants will win by 37 points. Next up is another tough game to tip for me, and that's Melbourne hosting the Saints at the MCG. To say the D's have been underwhelming this year is massive understatement. Now, they had a really hard-fought win last week against Sydney, but because of their 0-3 start to the season, they're playing catch-up massively and there's not a lot of more room for error. We saw Nathan Jones put out a real captain's performance last week, kicking 3 goals in 21 possessions, while Max Gawn had 55 hitouts in a bit of a return to form. Now, they come up against the Saints side that's quietly been getting the job done week after week. While I love what the Saints have been able to produce so far this year, it's important to contextualise and remember their wins have come against Gold Coast, a struggling Essendon side, and an undermanned Hawthorn outfit. This game does present a huge opportunity for them to go 4-1, and if they do, we'll have to talk about them as finals contenders. The problem with that is we just don't know what Melbourne side is going to turn up this week. Last year, the Saints did get the better of the D's in an absolute thriller, but this time the D's are probably playing for their season already. I'm going to tip Melbourne to win this game by 11 points. The next game is Richmond hosting the Sydney Swans at Marvel Stadium. Last week was a massive win for the Richmond Footy Club. They came up against a good side away from home and were undermanned and actually got the win. The Tigers have had their depth questioned in recent times, but they really stood up for the challenge on the back of guys like Dylan Grimes, Brandon Ellis, and Tom Lynch. That win will give them a lot of confidence going forward, particularly as their stars start to filter back through the side, starting with Dusty Martin this week. The Swans, as I predicted pre-season, have struggled to start the year. They're now 1-3 after a home loss to the struggling Demons. They did lead by 22 points at one point in the second quarter, but they really couldn't keep up with Melbourne after that. Now, Sydney, as I've said before, are going through a transitional phase, so there's a lot of new blood being filtered through that squad. As a result, they're probably carrying a lot of passengers as well. The Swans supposedly play Marvel Stadium pretty well, but nonetheless, I'm going to have to tip Richmond by 21 points. Next up, we have the Doggies hosting the Blues at Marvel Stadium. The Doggies come into this game following a spirited performance against last year's grand finalists, going down to Collingwood by 14 points. They sit 2-2 at the moment, with their major regret so far probably that 5-point loss at home to the Gold Coast. Nonetheless, they can probably be fairly content with where they sit so far, particularly on the back of the performance of their midfielders. The Bont in particular is having a brilliant season so far, and I believe he's actually equaled the record for most coaches' votes after round 4. Now, the Blues have been gallant in defeat 4 times this season without actually getting to take the points home. They really probably should have got the win last week against the Gold Coast, but let it slip in the dying minutes. Pat Cripps, as usual, was absolutely amazing, but the fact that the next best player for them was Sam Walsh probably speaks to how many contributors they've actually got at the moment. They are a young side, so I'm not heaping shit on them. And while I do think there is potential for an upset here, I'm going to tip the Bulldogs by 23 points. On Easter Sunday, we have Adelaide hosting the Gold Coast Suns at Adelaide Oval. Now, the Crows continued their lackluster start to the season last week with a loss to North in Melbourne. After being a top 4 fantasy for many people going into this season, they currently sit at 1-3 after 4 rounds and are only percentage out of the bottom 4. Now, the Crouch brothers have been pretty solid through the midfield this year, but like a few other clubs, they've probably got a case of too much coming down to too few. They have to see this home game against the Suns as an absolute must win, because if they lose, I reckon you can just about write them off this year. Now, the Suns have won a few hearts this season, going 3-1 after 4 rounds, which I don't think anyone could have seen coming. I've said it before, but they continue to prove us wrong week after week that they're not going to be easy beats this year. Incredibly, they've been 4 really close games as well for the Suns, and cumulatively, the margin is 11 points. That is an all-time record for 4 rounds into an AFL season. This game does present a huge challenge for them, and as unconvincing as Adelaide have been this season, I find it hard to imagine the Suns going there and getting the win again. I'm going to tip Adelaide to win this by 33 points. The Easter Monday clash this week, as usual, looks like it'll be a very interesting game between Hawthorn and Geelong at the MCG. Now, the Hawks have had 2 good wins this season and then 2 pretty ordinary losses against the Saints and the Bulldogs. Admittedly, O'Meara was a late omission for the game against the Saints, but for a side aiming for finals this year, that will go down as a huge missed opportunity. The Cats, on the other hand, sustained their first loss of the season against the Giants at home last week. Up until that point, the Cats probably looked like the form side of the competition in the first 3 weeks, and it took a very good Giants side to bring them down. Danger has been cleared to play this game after being reported, although it did take a pretty good stopping effort to shut him out of the game after quarter time. He was held to just 17 possessions, which would have been a huge factor in the Giants winning. The Hawks have won the last 2 clashes between these sides, but I'm going to go off the form lines of this season so far, and I'm going to tip the Cats. So I say Geelong win this game by 24 points. So that's all the tips for the round 5 of the 2019 season. As I said in my reacts video, guys, I won't be here next week to give you any videos at all. I'll be jetting off to Bali on Friday, so won't be back for about 7 days. On the plus side, however, Busher and I are getting together to do a podcast tomorrow morning, so hopefully we'll have that up sometime tomorrow afternoon for you to watch. Thanks for all the continued support, guys. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing for our weekly content. If you haven't already, please check out the link in the description to our Discord chat. That way you can chat with us and all of our other subscribers about footy constantly. Thanks, guys. And remember, this video was sponsored by My Ass. Remember, you can slip your meat into My Ass and sit back and enjoy. Just remember, everything tastes better eaten out of My Ass.